Hey, this is Dr. K from iMedicalSchool. Let's get to today's heavily tested and clinically important topic, understanding how to interpret hepatitis B serologies. As you know, hepatitis B is part of the hepatitis family of viruses. As a disease process, it affects up to 2 billion people worldwide and is a chronic infection in 350 million people. The problem with hepatitis B is that it can lead to both acute and chronic liver damage, making it a clinically important topic to understand. Now, interpreting hepatitis B serology is seen on every medical exam, from your steps to your board, so it's a must-know topic. Let's get started by creating a grid where we will go over the different serologies that you can obtain in diagnosing hepatitis B infections. First, we have your hepatitis B surface antigen. This is basically a protein that is shed when hepatitis B is in the body. It does not indicate whether there is an acute or chronic illness. Next, we have hepatitis B surface antibody. When the body detects hepatitis B, it can learn to fight off the virus, and in many people, they do develop complete remission from the disease. Hepatitis B surface antibody indicates the presence of some form of immunity to hepatitis B. Next, we have hepatitis B core antigen. The core antigen is shed in multiple situations. These situations include acute infection or very early on in an infection. Just as there is a core antigen, there's also a core antibody. The core antibody can be split up into IgM and IgG antibodies. Remember, IgM antibodies indicate the body is fighting off a new exposure or acute infection. IgG antibodies indicate the body has been exposed to the antigen for quite some time and may represent a chronic infection. Usually, most labs only report the total anti-hepatitis B core antibody, if it's positive or not. If it is positive, then generally the lab will give you the IgG levels, and then you can determine whether it's IgG or IgM positive that's causing the total to be positive. Finally, the last serology to discuss is hepatitis E antigen, which generally reflects infectivity, but largely will not indicate the type of infection that is present. Let's run through the scenarios you will commonly see and learn how to interpret the serologies together. Remember, it's important to pay attention to the positives and negatives in a serology panel. Let's start off with a simple example. You get hepatitis serologies and the entire panel is negative. Well, you know that it is likely this patient has not had any exposure or vaccination to hepatitis B. That is a fairly simple example, so now let's take this a step further and make it a little bit more difficult. Let's say the panel comes back with hepatitis B surface antigen negative, hepatitis B surface antibody positive, and total hepatitis B core antibody positive. How would you interpret these results? Well, first, if hepatitis B surface antigen is negative, the patient has not been exposed and has developed immunity, or is so early in the infection, the virus is not shedding surface antigen yet. This is called the window period. Next, the hepatitis B surface antibody is positive, so I know right away this patient is either immune due to vaccination or previous infection. Finally, total hepatitis B core antibody is positive, but the hep B core antigen is negative. This indicates the body has developed antibodies against antigen, creating immunity from hepatitis B, and with no surface or core antigens in the system, indicates the hepatitis B infection has resolved. Let's try another example. What if the entire hepatitis panel is negative except for the hepatitis B surface antibody? Well, if all the antigen markers are negative, that means no infection is present. If core antibody is negative, that means no previous exposure. Finally, with only hepatitis B surface antibody being positive, this means the patient is immune to hepatitis B due to vaccination. This is really important to remember. Next scenario is where surface antigen is positive, core antigen is positive, and IgM core antibody is positive. How would you interpret these results? Well, given surface antibody is negative, it means the patient has not developed immunity. Since both surface antigen and core antigen are positive, this patient has an active infection. Finally, the core IgM antibody being positive indicates an acute infection. Just to summarize, with antigens being positive and only IgM core antibody positive, this indicates an acute hepatitis B infection. In our fourth scenario, we have hepatitis B surface antigen positive and IgG hepatitis B core antibody positive. How would you interpret these results? Well, given we have serum antigen positive, we know the virus is present in the patient. But with core IgG positive, this indicates the patient has had this infection for quite some time, but has not developed immunity, indicating a chronic infection. Let's proceed to our last scenario. Imagine the panel comes back as surface antigen negative, surface antibody negative, but core antigen positive. What is the interpretation of this scenario? Well, this situation is rather confusing. With core antigen only being positive, the patient may have an infection that has resolved a long time ago, and because of no re-exposure, the body does not produce the surface antibodies to maintain immunity. Other possibilities include false positives. The patient may have never had hepatitis B, but just due to inaccuracies in the exam, the core antigen, it came back positive. The third possibility is that the patient has a low-level chronic infection. And finally, a fourth possibility would be the patient's acute infection resolving and a chronic infection may be setting in. What do you do in this situation? Well, I would just obtain a viral hepatitis B RNA titer. The levels are high, I know an acute or chronic infection is present, but if the levels are not significant, then I know this is probably a false positive. So the key point in interpreting hepatitis B serology is to always look at the positives and negatives in the panel. If you have surface antibody positive, you have some form of immunity, and if you have surface antigen positive, then there's some form of infection present. Well, that's a review of hepatitis B serology. I hope I made this simple and easy to understand. If you like this video, give it a like. Make sure to share this video with your friends on Facebook, Google+, and Twitter. You can follow us on Facebook at our page, iMedicalSchool, and Twitter at iMedSchool. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. And finally, subscribe. This is Dr. K, and I'll see you next time.